Alrighty, friends. So we're out here just enjoying a beautiful Missouri morning. Had our first successful hunt on the home farm this past week and wanted to bring you some footage from that. So without further ado, let's just jump right on into the hunt. Alright, guys, so I'll do a little pre-hunt interview. First hunt of the year. I believe it's September the 22nd. Unfortunately, had some family events that came up that kept me out of the woods until now, but actually it was probably fortunate that that was the case because I would have been tempted to hunt in 90 degree weather. And so we have the first cold front of the year. I didn't get out this morning. It was still kind of drizzly, rainy. So I decided to come out. We're on the farm this year. We got 56 acres here and then 71 acres back at home. So we don't lack for places to hunt, thank the Lord. Actually, we got close to 70 acres in and around here, but we'll be hard at it. We got wind coming out of the northeast, which is gonna really give us a good wind for where we're at tonight. We're gonna be sitting on top of a hill on a little hunting hole plot, so we should be seeing some deer. I'll give you some more updates as we get in the stand. But this year I'm gonna try to document the hunts, kind of film some more encounters and things of that nature, just give you some stuff to watch. I don't know that I'll be able to actually film a hunt, like a kill shot. Maybe we'll try to do that a little bit later in the year, get a setup that will allow us to do that. But right now we're just working with an iPhone. And I've debated on Tacticam, GoPro, all that kind of stuff. Don't really know that this year my goal is to kill a mature buck, and I really don't want to risk filming that in the interest of spooking the deer or get too preoccupied with that. I want to kill a mature deer. That is my management goal tonight. We're going to be satisfied with the doe, as long as she doesn't have fawns with her. And as long as she's, you know, not kind of rearing any young at this point. If the fawns look like they don't have spots and they were dropped really early this year, then that doe may be on the hit list. But a mature doe is on the target tonight. Got a nice 10 point and a nice, actually two nice 10 points and one nice 8 point that may be on the hit list tonight. We'll see if they walk in. If they do, it's going to be real hard to pass them up. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned. All right, guys, so we got set up here. I've got to be really quiet because I don't know deer bed and up here on this ridge a bunch. Tree stand I was going to. Unfortunately, we've had some inclement weather the last few days, and I guess something happened that caused it to shift. And so actually I am sitting on the ground, tucked into some brush. Not ideal, but gotta improvise and see what we can do. We don't have many other options. I'm certainly not walking out of here. So clover field in front of, right in front of us, and the wind is actually blowing in our face, and it's supposed to shift to be blowing over my left shoulder come the evening. So I think we're in a pretty good setup. I got some brush in front of me. I'm just gonna have to be super still, so don't expect many updates. I'll let you know when we get one. guys, so we are in the stand this afternoon. It's 12:30, got out here way early. Had to pick out a tree and find a tree, had to hang a set. So we're doing a little hanging hunt tonight. This is the first hunt on the homestead property. My house is probably 400 yards due north, over my left shoulder. This place here sets up quite nicely, actually. So the opening interview got interrupted by a bachelor group of $6. That's pretty exciting. Pretty good stuff. Anyway, I'm going to keep it short. I'll tell you a little bit more about this spot. Once the rain settles down a little bit, you can hear me a little better. Stay tuned. Alright guys, so now that the weather is kind of subsided a little bit, we're back in the stand. It was just raining cats and dogs earlier, so I unfortunately didn't dress properly, so I got down, snuck out, went back to the house, got dry, warm, put on some scent lock, and came back out, some waterproof stuff. The stuff I thought I had on wasn't, I thought it was waterproof, but it was just water resistant, so we saw those $6 about 30 minutes after we got in the stand, checked a few cameras, now we're back, we got some turkeys in the field, in front of me. Right. to the south of me. But I wanted to tell you a little bit about how this stand sets up. So we're basically on a fence corner. The fence running east to west, it backs up to some fields that are not on my property. But then the fence running north to south, it is contained in the entirety of my property. And so what these deer are doing is basically this fence is continued on from the very northern part of my property and to the south, and it corners back here against this fence running east to west. But then if you continue south, you got a big hedgerow of trees. And so what I believe deer are doing is they're using these two fields to feed, but if they're moving one way or the other, they're going to walk along this hedgerow of trees. And so I'm basically just inside the woods from that hedgerow of trees. You can kind of see the hedgerow of trees right there. There's a field here and a field there, and that hedgerow goes in length, goes all the way out both of those fields and connects to a bigger block of timber. So I'm basically in a big funnel. Not only have I got that funnel working for me, in front of me and to my left is a ridge line that ends up in a cliff that's it's really hard to traverse, but on the top it plateaus, and right out in front of me there's a really super thick cedar thicket that runs with that fence line that goes east to west. And so I think deer are going to be using that security cover and bedding. So I've got that funnel, that cliff, and that real steep ridge, and this fence line east to west. But I've also got the fence line north to south that continues into that funnel of the hedgerow. So we're looking up. It's looking to be a really good sit tonight. Got a slight breeze. The wind is blowing over my left shoulder, which is back towards the pond, away from the security cover and away from this hedgerow of trees, where I think I might be able to catch something coming tonight. Anything's fair game. Primarily looking for a doe, or we'd be happy with a really big buck. Any time of the year is a good time of the year to kill a big buck. So don't have very many pictures on the property, on the homestead. I kind of goofed. I set up my cameras in such a way that I thought I'd get more pictures of bigger deer. I've got one solid 10-point that he's got a kicker off of his G2 on the left side. That looks to be a pretty good deer, but the pictures are, he's about 30, 40 yards away. He's probably about 30 yards away from the camera when I got a picture of him. So it's just hard to tell how big he is. Anyway, looking forward to tonight. And we'll catch back up with you when we get something on the ground. Alright guys, so we're back in the same spot we were in last night. Got the same wind, expecting most of the deer to come from the southeast of me here. And the wind is a southeast wind. And so it's just due south. Turkey cackling in the field. So we might put one of those down if they give us an opportunity. They're hard to kill with the bow. So, anyway, that's a cool morning. We'll be switching. Our afternoon hunt's going to be over a winter wheat field down in a creek bottom. So we'll be on low in the evening. High in the morning, low in the evening. So, it's looking pretty good. Don't know if I'll take a doe during this hunt or not, just because I know tonight I'm likely to have an opportunity at a doe. So, I really don't want to booger this spot up too bad. But if one presents an opportunity, then it's meat for the freezer. Anyway, wish me luck. I'll see if I can lay down some decent footage for you if we're not going to kill something. And if we do kill something, we'll pick you back up on the blood trail. Thanks for watching. Yes, sir. Caught a few deer sneaking in behind me. And I think I heard her crash. But she was at 30 yards. I think I put in a real nice shot. Heard a real nice pop. Could tell she was limping when she was running away. So we'll get you back up on the blood trail. Nice mature doe came in with the fawn. Fawn didn't have any spots left, so I think the fawn's going to be just fine to make it through. It'll probably find another doe group to hang out with, but first one on the homestead, baby. First deer down for this year. It's a good hunt. Good hunt. Good hunt. Only two deer I saw. Saw a lot of turkey. That was it. Caught him coming in behind me directly. She was directly downwind, got the scent lock on. And the fawn didn't like, I had to stand up. The fawn didn't like what he or she saw. But mama was just far enough away that, and the sun is actually at my back. You can see the sun is at my back. So it's real hard for them to be able to see me and pick me out of the tree. But anyway, we'll step down and we'll go get the arrow. I think I heard her crash, probably not more than maybe 100 yards from where I shot her. So we'll see. Looks like he's a little button buck. He was with that doe, but man, he ain't got no spots, so fair game. He should be just fine. Alright, we're at the place where I shot her. My tree stand is over there. You can see the red strap on the tree. I don't see my arrow just yet, and I don't see any blood, but I know she's hit, and her fawn came back up by the tree stand alone. So I think now the first order of business is just to find some blood. Which shouldn't be too terribly hard, but I'll get back with you when I find some blood, and we'll go from there. All right. guys, gals. So we've got the arrow here. Let's go see what we got. Looks like a complete pass through. Oh yeah. Broadhead don't even look like it didn't work. That arrow's covered in nice bright red blood. Don't smell any gut material on it, so go ahead and stack that up. And I did end up finding some blood over here, so we'll put that arrow in the quiver and we'll start on the blood trail and we'll see how things progress. One thing with these small fixed blade broadheads is you don't get much of a blood trail, as I've been told, so this would be my first kill in a long time with a fixed blade, so we'll see how things go. So we got first blood, and it's not spraying everywhere, but I think I heard her crash in this direction here, so let's kind of meander on over here and see what we got. Hoping we got a dead deer. Oh, I see something over there. I see something. You know what they say, dead deer don't run. Looky here. What a nice doe. Looks like, yep. There she is, boy. What a shot. Put it to her. What a nice doe. Oh yeah. Right there in front of the shoulder. Nice big doe. We'll get her. We're gonna get the side by side up here and we'll go from there. First harvest on the new property. What a cool deal. What a cool deal. Looks like we got a heart shot there. But she's got, yeah, nice doe. At least a 2-year-old, maybe older. Got a nice long snoot on her. But cool deal, guys. Well, I'll get her out of here, get her cleaned up, and we'll get some better pictures. Oh yeah, heart shot, baby. That was a good one. But all right, we'll get right to you.
So first harvest on the home property. House is about 400 yards that way, and it's a nice doe. Shot her at 30 yards. Got the Elite Impulse 31. Got the Annihilator broadheads, blew through both shoulders. This is the exit wound here, so looks like probably got a heart shot. We're gonna get her taken care of, cleaned up, and excited to have some meat for the freezer. Stay tuned.